You guys have been pretty strong in kind of the lower price point market for a tablet. This Fire Max 11 has a higher price point. It looks and feels a little bit more premium. Who are you trying to capture with this latest tablet?
Well, I think we've really found a place with our tablet products where we build kind of premium tablets, but at non-premium prices. And as customers have demanded more from tablets, they've increasingly said they wanted larger screens. We have had 10-inch screens for a while, but bringing out the 11-inch now, it's a real big difference for us because we did go to an all-aluminum design. It's thinner. It's really a great opportunity for customers to have a larger tablet form factor that can also be used for productivity as well as entertainment, but also be able to do it at an incredibly affordable price. It's just $229.
Right, and this one is definitely geared, it seems, to increase productivity for workers. But I noticed that a lot of your products have a kids version, the Echo Show 5 Kids, that are designed for kids, or they're designed for kids, like the now canceled Amazon Glow. How do you think about incorporating and building out generative AI and LLM when it comes to serving the kids? Because there's a privacy factor, obviously, that is critical to retaining, to building, to preserving that trust with your customer base.
Yeah, and we've had a version of our kids' products, as you said, for a long time now. We have it for Kindle, we have it for our tablets, we have it for our Echoes, and even Fire TV. And the key around that is we really try to build a kind of a sandbox that the parents can ensure they feel safe putting their kids in that environment. For example, on our tablets, all the apps that are available through Kids Plus don't have any embedded advertising in them. And I think the same thing's true with Alexa and generative AI, that the AI has to be aware of the age group that it is talking to. So if a child that's 6 years old asks where do babies come from, it's going to give a different, more parent-friendly answer than if an adult asks that question.
I know chatbots are certainly having their moment. Generative AI seems to be the phrase we can't stop talking about. But you guys, with Alexa, with the Echoes, chatbots have been around with you for a minute. I'm curious what you think at this moment in time of all the calls for regulation around generative AI and chatbots. It's an industry that you guys have clearly been in. And I think I remember Amazon asking for regulation around facial recognition software. What's your take on AI these days? Are you going to go to Congress and say, hey, you need to help us out here?
Yeah, I think there's a wide spectrum of what AI can deliver. And, you know, on one end of the spectrum, when you start talking about these generative AI techniques and assistance and things like that, I think there's very much room for regulation. And we think that we want that to happen as Amazon. There are other sides that are just not as risky. And, you know, think about things like fraud detection. And then those kind of places, you probably want to have less regulation so you can keep the speed of invention happening and protect consumers with those AI techniques. But in the long run, we think for the more complicated use scenarios that regulation is needed, and we're big supporters.
I want to go back to products for a moment, because I'm so glad that Alex brought up Alexa, and you did as well. When you talk about generative AI, can you give us a sense of what capabilities are going to be first through the door as you try to upgrade Alexa and make it more prevalent in people's lives? What are you doing to make Alexa smarter, essentially?
Yeah, well, the first thing, we hit a big milestone. We've now sold well over 500 million Alexa-enabled devices. And last week, we announced the Echo Pop here. This is the first product I ever brought home that my daughter said was adorable. So I'm very proud of the team's ability to do that. But with over 500 million endpoints, we have a great access to customers. And we are using generative AI techniques to improve it every day. And I'll give you an example, which is on the back end, we have a large language model that runs that takes multiple pieces of information from various parts of the web and our own repositories and comes up with a concise answer. So if a child asks a homework question or a parent asks a question, then we give a better answer than we did just weeks ago. And this is all because of the power of these large language models. And over the course of time, you're going to see us roll out even more. And Alexa's just going to get more proactive and more conversational.
David, I have to ask about Astro, the adorable home robot that was released as a prototype. Is everyone going to be able to get their hands on Astro? Is there a wider release coming up for that product?
We continue to make progress on Astro. We're shipping a lot of them every week now. We've kind of ramped up the manufacturing, but we're still an invite. There's still a few areas that we're working on in terms of navigation, but it seems like it's a pretty tractable problem right now, and I would anticipate it to go into wide release over the course of the not too far in the distant future as we get through the last of the issues. But I will tell you that customers are loving the product. We've had over 300,000 people request invites. We're shipping lots every week. And customers have kind of, if there was a spectrum of products and your phone was on one end and a pet was on the other, Astro is kind of closer to the pet end of the spectrum than it is to your iPhone.